شهر الله سبحانه وتعالى محرم، شهر الله محرم. المحرم هي عند منطق محرم. المحرم is the first month of the Islamic calendar and it is one of the sacred month, the first month of the Islamic calendar. And in this month Allah جل وعلا saved موسى عليه السلام from who? From Fir'aun. Allah جل وعلا saved موسى عليه السلام from Fir'aun in this month. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Medina and he saw the Jews fasting on a particular day, he asked, why are they fasting today? And they said, this was the day that Allah saved Musa from Fir'aun. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, we have more right to Musa than them. So then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fast on this day. This is the 10th of Muharram. Fast on this day. And this will be an expiation for an entire year of sins. 1 year of sins will be forgiven with the fast of Muharram. And that's what the scholars say, the greatest fast, the voluntary fast, is the fast of Arafah. It expiates 2 years of sins, the previous year and the coming year. And the fast of Muharram, Ashura, it expiates the year of sin, the previous year of sin. And this will be Monday, inshallah ta'ala. So Monday is a day that everyone should fast. And then the Prophet ﷺ commanded us to differ ourselves from the Jews. So he told us to fast the day before. Because the Jews, they only fast one day. And the Prophet ﷺ wanted to differ with them in everything that they did. When he first came to Medina, he would copy them in everything that they did and follow them. Because he said, these are the people of the book. So we are better following them than having the traditions of the Quraysh. So he would comb his hair the way they would comb their hair. He would do everything that they would do. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet to differ with the Jews, so he began to comb his hair in a different way. And he began to do everything differently until the Jews, they said, what is it with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Every time he sees us doing something, he wants to do something different. So that's how much he wanted to differ with the Jews. So the Prophet said, fast the day before Ashura and the day of Ashura. So fast the 9th of this month, which is Sunday, and the 10th of this month. This is how a person should fast, the 9th and the 10th. If he is unable to fast the 9th, he should fast the 10th and the 11th. There is no authentic hadith to say we should follow fast on the 11th. But this fulfills the meaning of differing with the Jews. So if you are unable to fast the 9th and the 10th, then fast the 10th and the 11th. If you are unable to fast 2 days, then fast just the 1 day. So the best thing to do is to fast the 9th and the 10th, Sunday and Monday. If you are unable to fast Sunday and Monday, then the next best thing to do is to fast the 10th and the 11th, Monday and Tuesday. And if you are unable to fast 2 days, then the thing which is sufficient, inshallah ta'ala, is for you to just to fast the 10th, inshallah ta'ala, of this month. And this will be the expiation for the previous year of sins, inshallah ta'ala. So this is something, make the intention for this, inshallah ta'ala. If now someone says, and this is I think this is the following chapter in the kitab, the Bab al-Iyad, no, the chapter. So not the following chapter, it's the chapter after this. That whatever a person usually does or wants to do, but he is unable to do because of an illness, he will still receive the reward. So a sister might say, I'm going to be on my cycle on this weekend. I will not be able to fast. You had the intention to fast? Yes. If you were not on your cycle, would you have fasted? Yes. Look at the rahmah of Allah. She would get the reward of fasting. The year will be forgiven for her. And she didn't fast because she was unable to fast. This is the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person now, he is unwell and he was going to fast, but he has great weakness or he's suffering from a fever and a cold. He's unable to fast, but he would have fasted if he was well. It is as if he is fasting. So inshallah ta'ala, try and fast this day. If you are unable to fast because something has happened, then the reward is still with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you are making the intention now. And that's what I'm saying, make the intention that you're going to fast this day, inshallah ta'ala. And this is the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also find that some event took place on the 10th of Muharram. Does anyone know which event took place in history on the 10th of Muharram? The killing of Hussein radiallahu anhu. The killing of Hussein radiallahu anhu. And just like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, we have more right to Musa than the Jews, we have more right to Hussein than the Shia. And they disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day by beating themselves and harming themselves, saying that because obviously they did treachery against Hussein. But we have more right to Hussein than they do. So do not think that Hussein is one of them. Hussein is one of the leaders of the children of paradise. One of the most beloved people to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we defend the honor of Hussein, and we defend the rights of Hussein, and we love Hussein more than them. Many people, because of the Shia, when they hear the name of Ali, or the name, they hear the name of Hassan and Hussein, they don't have that love that they have when they hear the name of Abu Bakr and Umar. You know, Ali, after these three, is the greatest Muslim to step foot on this earth, after the Anbiya and these three. And as for his sons, Hassan and Hussein, they are the greatest children on this earth. And the Prophet said, they will be the leaders of the children of paradise. So the believers have to understand that they are our companions. They are the companions of the Prophet. They are our role models. They are inspiration to us. And we love them more than the Shia love them. And we follow their traditions more than the Shia follow their traditions. And we, inshallah ta'ala, will be in Jannah with them, while the Shia will be in Jahannam with the Shayateen. Because they are from the people of the disbelievers. So these are, they are companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sunnis, they are the followers of these companions. As for the Shia, they would worship them. And as some of the ulama, they mentioned that the reason why Allah Jalla wa Ala has decreed that they would beat themselves on this day is because they have accused Aisha radiallahu anha of zina. Some of them accused Aisha radiallahu anha of zina. And others accused other wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of zina. So Allah Jalla wa Ala has made them lash themselves every year until Yawm al-Qiyamah. And some of the ulama mentioned this is the punishment that Allah Jalla wa Ala has given them. Whether this is true or it is not, we can find that they are punishing themselves in this way. And they are harming themselves and they are opposing the Sharia and doing this anyway. So we have to understand that the day of Ashura is the day that we fast because the Prophet ﷺ fasted because Musa ﷺ was given victory. And it is the day that Allah Jalla wa Ala will forgive our sins for an entire year if we fast. And we also remember that this was the day that Hussein was killed because of the Rafida, because of the Shia. And we have more right to Hussein than they do, so we should defend his honor. And we should speak about how much we love him and how much they actually do not love him because they were treacherous to him and they have gone against the sunnah of their grandfather who was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they have gone away from the deen and the religion of their grandfather who was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So these are important points for Muslim to understand and important points for Muslim to know. And we completely do bara'at from them. We disassociate ourselves completely from them. So sometimes we find that they are giving Islam a bad image. No. Portray it clearly. If you have platforms, if you have anything, portray it clearly that they are not upon our religion. We are not upon their religion. What they are doing is not from Islam, and they are not from Islam. And this is, there is no guidance from them, from the Prophet ﷺ that they follow, and they are from the worst of the disbelievers, because they are murtaddin, and the apostate is worse than the disbeliever. But this is, so we have to disassociate ourselves from these people, and we have to disassociate ourselves from their beliefs, and we have to disassociate ourselves from their actions and their crimes. And this is the meaning of al-wala wal-bara, that we know who to associate ourselves with, and who to disassociate ourselves with. So inshaAllah ta'ala, the main thing from this is the fast of Ashura, which is on Monday inshaAllah ta'ala. Fast on Sunday and Monday if you can. If you can't, then Monday and Tuesday. If you can't, then just Monday inshaAllah ta'ala will be sufficient for the forgiveness for an entire year. And we ask Allah to accept our good deeds.